Pat Olson alongside the USF head coach Frank Lavricia as we continue along with more USF Dons volleyball. It's a senior day here on the Hilltop as the Dons go up against the Pepperdine Waves. And, Coach, before we get into the, you know, mechanisms of the matchup and all that, you've done this a lot, you know, been the head coach and watched senior players graduate and play in their last home game. What kind of emotion is involved with all of that?
Definitely emotion. And, you know, the thing for myself as a coach, what we want to see is them, you know, use it so that it's an advantage and not that it doesn't impair them and them wanting to be their best, you know, on their last home match. So I think getting them to realize, you got a job to do here, and we really appreciate what you've done for the program. And so... Do a great job for us, and hopefully your last match is a great experience.
Let's talk about it from the coaching standpoint. And obviously, this being your first year, you don't have deep recruiting history bringing, you know, players in here on the Hilltop as freshmen. But you've been down that road before, and I know that's your mission to go down that road here. What's it like for you as a coach when you've had a player for a long period of time, recruited them, have seen them kind of mature from that, you know, 18-year-old to that young 22-year-old, and they walk off into the world with a college degree, and in some part because you as a head coach, you know, said, hey, come play for me.
Yeah, it's a kind of a love-hate relationship in the sense that you hate to see them go because you've invested so much, but you know that's the way it is going in. And so so you just got to live with it and hopefully prepare them as best as you can for their next 40 years, you know, with the 4 years while they were here. Certainly it's a tough thing, but it's, you know, the nature of the way the sports is designed here in the States. I think it's awesome, and just in the locker room before the match tonight, how the rest of the team, you know, kind of rallied around them, and they know, you know, they know. What we would always do is be a little bit careful about how much emotion, you know, and try to do a lot of things after the match, you know, after the fact, and just focus on playing and giving your best performance. Yeah,
both Blackwell and Bouvard Plavik playing their final games at home as seniors here on Senior Day from inside One Memorial at the Sobrato Center. You know, Coach, as a guy that's been around a long time, you mentioned you have him for those 4 years. How many of your former players, you know, still reach out to you? And what does that mean to you when you have those relationships that go more beyond the, just the 4 years?
You know, it's awesome, and obviously not all the relationships were rosy, but I was fortunate to have a good mixture and a lot of great people and players, and I got a text from last Thursday night's match afterwards, and this one alum, her daughter plays in high school down in San Diego, and she's like, hey, Coach, your recruit from down here looks awesome. You know, great player, good job. You know, so you
still get that.
Yeah, and so it's reaffirming for us that, you know, we're on the right track, we're doing the right things, and she's looking for her daughter to come here as well, and hopefully, you know, she grows and she'd be able to help out the Dons as well. But it's a precious thing, you know, that to hear from the alum and know. You know how valuable the experience was to them.
Do you ever get that surprise? And I know we've been on this a while, but I like the topic. Jim Brevelli, who does color with me on the radio side on men's basketball games, when I started, I've been here so long, he was the head basketball coach. And he says, you know, there are, you said they're not always rosy relationships, but he says two or three times, Pat, he said, over the years I've run into it. We've been in a gym somewhere, and a former player that I thought we didn't get along that well has walked up to me and thanked me for what I did for them as a young man. Do you ever get that kind of surprise once in a while?
Once in a while you get that, yeah. And, you know, we know not everybody's going to be on the same timetable. Sometimes they grow up while they're in front of you. Sometimes they're grown up when you get them. And sometimes they grow up after the experience. And so you do the best you can, and hopefully it goes the right way in the long run. In the long run.
Yeah. Let's talk about this Pepperdine team to the match at hand. Tell us about the Waves. I know you saw them earlier in the year, and we saw them play here even earlier than that because they were in your tournament way back in, I think it was late August. So what were we going to expect to see from this Pepperdine team here today?
You know, Pepperdine's always got this history of ball control, whether it's the beach or being from Southern California, but they know how to play the game. They play it the right way. They've got great setters, whichever one they go with. Their outside hitters do a nice job. They've got a great young middle out of Oregon who's just does a great job, in the center position there. So I expect the same. We actually out-dug them down at their place, one of our better defensive efforts. And that's our focus for tonight is, let's have that defensive intensity and be able to play great defense against a reputable program. And then we just have to defend, 21, a 6'4 kid, does a really nice job, and we got to defend her well and then generate a little bit more offense on our end. So we're hoping that Nora does a great job that way, that Carly's been our steadiest scorer, and see if we can get a little bit more out of our middles. See if Ashman can put together a great match and Rhonda as well. So if we can get a combination of those attackers to score for us at a higher level, do a little bit of better job blocking at the net, and come back with our great defensive effort on the floor, then I like our chances. Yeah, we had a great practice yesterday. Yeah.
All right, that's first-year head coach Frank Labriccia, USF and Pepperdine here on Senior Day from inside One Memorial at the Sobrato Center. I'm Pat Olson here on the W.TV.